Hey! With Enscape 4.1, we are adding two new artistic rendering modes. Sketch and watercolor. These provide easy access to simplified visuals with various settings for you to create your artistic visualization style with. Let's first explore the black and white sketch mode before hopping over to the watercolor mode. Keep in mind that all you're about to see can be used for still images, for videos, or just presenting directly from your model. For example, by hopping from 3D view to 3D view and letting the view settings update the scene. You can find the mode selection on the main tab of the visual settings. Selecting Sketch from the mode selection will instantly change your Enscape view to a simplistic representation consisting only of white background and black outlines, simulating a pen or pencil sketch. The visual settings interface will change as well. The next setting below now shows an outline thickness selection slider. Use this to change the prominence of your outlines. You'll notice that when selecting None, with these settings, you'll see only white. This will make sense once we get to the Hatched Shadows setting you see further down. For now, let's settle with Thin, Normal or Thick and move on to the Jitter setting. This setting will add a wavy look to the lines and can reduce the unnatural perfection a bit, which helps to create a more natural look. Speaking of adding a more natural look, the extended lines slider below that will continue the strokes of our imaginative pen or pencil, adding a more pronounced sense of a drawn visualization. The next step is to select the color our pencil uses. We can choose between pen, pencil, and colored pencil, referring to a deep black for pen, a lighter gray for pencil, and the colors of your visualization for colored pencil. We can easily reduce the amount of detail of our visualization further by disabling transparent glass. Let's focus on the outside here. So much better for a simple drawing. The last setting we've unlocked by choosing sketch mode is called Hatched Shadows. Quite self-explanatory, it will bring shadows back into our simplified visualization as if hatched with a pencil. Now you know what can be seen when outlines further up is set to none. The Hatched Shadows setting applies a texture overlay only on the parts of the visualization that receive less light. It's great to add more detail to the visualization without adding too much complexity. With the Hatched Shadows setting enabled, it's worth checking out the palette options again, as each will have its own hatching style, depending on the type of pen selected. Let's change the mode selection to watercolor now. Again, we'll find the outline's thickness setting at the top. Just like with the colored pencil setting in sketch mode, the outlines now take a matching color to the underlying materials. Similar to when the Hatched Shadows option was enabled in sketch mode, you'll notice a static texture overlay, this time mimicking the pattern that results when painting a picture with watercolors. You can increase the vibrance of this effect by dialing up the value of the color gradient setting. This will act as if both more color and more water was used during the painting. You can further strengthen this impression using the bleeding effect slider. This will in turn mix colors outside of their model boundaries, as if the color mixed while still wet. And, just like before, the transparent glass setting allows us to easily remove unwanted detail from the image by blocking out interior or exterior parts of the scene. With this, we hope you can expand the artistic range of your design visuals with Enscape. Thank you for being with us. Until next time.